From 2019, all cars produced by Volvo will have an electric motor, marking the end of cars that only have an internal combustion engine. The announcement, made in early July this year, stated that electrification is at the core of our future business. Volvo Cars Explorers is in Shanghai, China, right in the heart of the largest electric vehicle market in the world. The Explorers' mission here is to take a closer look at the market and learn what makes Volvo Cars well prepared to meet a rising global demand for electric vehicles.
We are going to meet Mr. Xu Feng. He's going to tell us about the electric vehicles market in China.
Is the Chinese public interested in electric vehicles?
Yeah, they did some study. Chinese customer compared to other country, they have a very high percentage of people want to accept the electric vehicle. Two factors. One is the environment issue. You know, in China, in some city, the environment is not very good. You know, the pollution. Another one is when operate the electric vehicle, the cost is very low compared to conventional gas vehicle. Yeah, so that's why customers like it.
Data by the International Energy Agency shows that there are now over 2 million fully electric vehicles and plug-in hybrids in the world. The market is driven by stricter legislation, changing customer preferences, and last but not least, lower prices.
So if we're able to solve the price point issue of electric vehicles, is the infrastructure ready to handle the demand?
Yeah, infrastructure is one factor, currently. So government put a big efforts to build up this, charging port, like behind. I hear that in Shanghai, government is going to put like 5,000 charging station. So I think if that happen, so I think the auto market, the EV market will be more popular, yeah.
When I heard that the market, the electric vehicle market was as big as it is, I saw there's a lot of room for opportunity, but that meant that there were a lot of challenges ahead. It's a big task to move the industry to electrification. And I think that we're headed in the right direction. The process needs to start now.
Apart from the incentives that customers will get from the government, the people very concerned about the environment that will make them switch to electric vehicles.
For people, of course, they want to pay less, right? Yeah, this is reasonable. Since we can find the car, have a lower price, right? But the environment people also concerned. That is more sustainable for the society, for everyone. So people also, if the price acceptable or even higher, they still want to drive electric vehicle.
Volvo has a commitment to sell a total of 1 million electrified cars by 2025. In 2019, the company will launch a pure electric car to the market for the first time. The model will be produced in China and exported globally.
Why do you think it's important to do research and development on electric vehicles here in Shanghai?
Mm-hmm. First of all, the Chinese market is the largest one in the world for electric vehicle. So also this market, the customer have some special requirement. So that's why if we do research and development here, so you are more close to our customer, so you can develop more people like. We have a different responsibility. So for Shanghai team, we probably do more localization. For example, Gothenburg team more focus on the product development. Yeah, so it's a joint effort.
Besides China, the most important markets for electric vehicles are Europe and the US. The very same as Volvo Cars' three main sales regions. This is one of the reasons why Volvo Cars are well prepared for a maturing electric car market. Another great advantage is our platforms. Anton and Cherie meet research and development engineers Wang Chenchen and Liang Haibo.
I think it's good to have that sort of presence here also, especially in the electrification R&D. I think that's important, especially in China where they have pollution problems. Electrified vehicle is going to be very important here in the future.
Wang Chenchen and Liang Haibo explain that the SPA and CMA platforms are vital for our electrified future, since they both support plug-in and pure electric configurations. The fact that the two platforms have so much in common also makes work more effective.
For example, like the test verification work, So we know how to do the test for the smart platform in China side, especially for some China unique standard homologation side. So we know a lot from the experience from smart platform. And in the future, if we used for the CMA platform, it's much more easier. So we can much more efficient this kind of work.
The announcement Volvo Cars made this summer that every new Volvo car from 2019 will have an electric motor was historic.
I'm a new mom. I think I want to create a more green world for my baby. So I really proud that I work in here to produce a more environmental car.
Especially in China, in Shanghai, we have a very big problem for the, you know, the pollution, the air pollution area. So if we choose an electrification vehicle in the future, maybe replace the conventional vehicle, petrol vehicle, and maybe we can save the Shanghai and save the China also, I think.